Let's start the performance with a little story. A story that happened a long time ago. This story happened during the time of the master, Abdul Baha. And this story began with a simple thought, a simple act, and a simple strand of love.
This year, in 2015, millions of friends around the world received a letter of love, a letter urging them to change their lives and transform society through service.
The initial stirrings of activity arise out of the love of Baha'u'llah, held in the heart of a committed believer. All activity begins with the simple strand of love. It is the vital thread from which is woven a pattern of patient and concentrated effort, cycle after cycle.
Nettie was prayerfully going about her work, praying praying in her heart that she may find a way to contribute to the building of this temple, she heard a voice.
Do you believe in immortality?
Yes, I do.
Then find a stone.
She continued with her work, not knowing quite what to make of this voice. And then the next day, the voice came again.
Do you believe in immortality?
Yes, I do.
Then find a stone.
A stone, a stone. She carried on. And then for the third time, in an even more commanding voice, she heard,
Do you believe in immortality?
Yes, I most certainly do.
Then find a stone.
And so she did, and she went to the nearest construction site. And there she picked her way amongst the rubble and the rocks, and she met the two foremen. And she told them of her dream, the story, to build a temple on the shores of Lake Michigan, a temple to universal peace. They loved her story, but unfortunately had no stones. Well, except this one. It's the one the builders refused. You can have that. Nettie, grateful, looked at the stone that would be her contribution. But how would she carry it? With the assistance of a helpful neighbor, she decided to pull it home. She got it home, she thought about the long journey across this huge city, just her and the stone. How would she carry it? And then she remembered a friend who had a baby carriage. She would put it in the baby carriage. So she began pushing the carriage. She pushed it to the nearest streetcar station and waited for the streetcar to arrive. She approached the conductor and told her her story and asked if she could put the stone on the streetcar. The conductor was not in a good mood that day and refused. Luckily, his colleague was kind-hearted and suggested that Nettie roll her stone to the back plate so as not to get in the way of the passengers. The streetcar crossed the city. And when Nettie came off the streetcar, there were only 6 blocks to go. But 6 blocks, 1 rock, and only 1 Nettie. What would she do? What would she do? And at the moment where she might give up, her brother, Leo Ledroot, and their dear friend, Mirza Mazlun, came. They decided to try and push the stone together. And so they pushed. And they pushed. And they were exhausted. And just at that point, 2 of their Baha'i friends, Corinne True and Cecilia Harrison, joined them. At this point, Mirza Mazlun heroically said, I will carry the stone on my back. And they placed the stone on the old man's back. And in the fading light of the day, he struggled and he sweated. And he carried that stone for half a block until he could carry it no more. They left the stone and returned home. Night fell, and the stone was alone. The next morning, just after dawn, Nettie came with a homemade cart. tried to maneuver the cart towards the stone, but as she did, she broke the handle of the cart. Oh, what to do? But just at that point, a friendly repair woman came, and she helped her to repair the cart. Once they fixed it, they decided to push together. And they pushed. The cart squeaked and strained. It was not enough. Just at that point, a newsboy who was handing out the morning papers came by. They pulled him in too, and he agreed. The three of them pushed the cart. Only a few meters to go, and they would be at the temple site. They pushed, and they pushed, and on the final push, the cart fell apart. And there the stone remained for another few years, waiting, waiting, waiting for the 2nd of May, 1912, when the master, Abdul Baha, would come to consecrate the ground where the first temple of the West would be built. Many stones had been sent for from around the world, many precious, beautiful stones, but they never arrived. So on that day, the only stone that remained was the stone that the builders refused. And that was the stone that Abdul Baha chose. And as he broke the ground, he said,
"The temple has already built."
Thank you. I just don't want to say very much except that I've really been very touched, moved and inspired to work with this group. Your pursuit of excellence is amazing. Thank you so much.